Let's study about gravitational interaction energy for a system of particles. In the previous section, we have studied about this interaction energy for a two-particle system. And the same expression we are going to modify. Here we can write for a given n-mass system, and which say the masses taken are m1, m2 and so on up to mn, which are separated from each other by distances which are given as r12, r13 and so on up to rij. Like r12 is the separation between particles of masses m1 and m2, r13 is the separation between m1 and m3 and so on. Then the interaction energy or the potential energy, gravitational potential energy of such a system can be given as, in this system, this gravitational energy UG we can write as it is negative of half of summation of I equals to 1 to n, summation of j equals to 1 to n, and it is gmimj by rij. And how I have written this expression, let's understand it very carefully. I'll explain it with the help of a simple example of a three-particle system. Say we are given with three masses m1, m2 and m3, and they are having separation r12 between particles 1 and 2, this is r13 between particles 1 and 3, and r23 between particles m2 and m3. If we wish to find out the gravitational potential energy for this system, as per definition we have studied that the gravitational potential energy is work done in assembling these particles from infinity to this position. So let's consider m1 was earlier at rest and m2 is brought from infinity to this point. We know well that the work done against the gravitational forces of m1 and m2 can be written as minus g m1 m2 by r12. And when m3 is now brought later, work has to be done against two forces. One is the gravitational force of M1 on M3 as well as gravitational force of M2 on M3. So in this situation, as gravitational field is a conservative field, we can simply write the independent works as work done depends only on initial and final position, not on the path. So work done against the forces of M1 in bringing M3 from infinity to here will be minus gm1 m3 over r13, and work done in bringing m3 from infinity to this point against the forces of m2 will be minus g m2 m3 over r23. So this is the way how we can find, and even if all the three will be brought together to this configuration, then also work will be same as gravitational field is conservative. So here we can see in this expression, you can see what we have done. For any number of particles, we can find out the possible number of pairs, and corresponding to each pair of particles, we find out the gravitational potential energy by using the expression of two-particle system, and we add all these terms as energy is a scalar. And in this expression, you can see again we are doing the same. gm1 m2 by r12, this gives us the gravitational potential energy between particles 1 and 2. But if we use the sigma summation and we take mimj, in this situation you can see I will vary from 1 to n, j will also vary from 1 to n. So in this situation, all pair of particles will be taken twice if we go for this double summation. That's why you can see I have just kept 0.5 or half outside this expression, which will cancel it out. Like here, if I consider all pairs, there can be six possibilities: m1, m2, m1, m3, then m2, m1, m2, m3, then m3, m1, m3, m2. So each term will be taken twice. So if I use this expression, I'll take half outside. So this will give me the same expression which we are calculating by taking all the pair one time and writing down the expression of energy for a two particle system. So always remember, both are these ways are good enough to find out the gravitational potential energy for a given system of particle.